Now the next question is, an ellipse is drawn with major and minor axis of length 10 and 8 respectively, using one focus as center. A circle is drawn that is tangent to the ellipse, with no part of the circle being outside the ellipse. Then the radius of this circle is, so we have this ellipse. Whose equation is x square upon 25 plus y square upon 16 equals to 1. So this point is 5 comma 0 minus 5 comma 0, 0 comma 4 and 0 comma minus 4. Now we'll find its eccentricity. So it'll be 16 equals 25, 1 minus e square. So value of e is simply 3 by 5 and its focus will be plus minus a comma 0. So it will be plus minus 3 comma 0. So one of the focus is at 3 comma 0 and the other one is at minus 3 comma 0. So it says using one of the focus as center, a circle is drawn which is tangent to this ellipse. So we have drawn a circle which touches this ellipse. Then we need to find radius of this circle. Now this circle touches this ellipse, then parametric point on this circle must be equal to parametric point on this ellipse. So we'll take point on this circle. We can write point on this circle as 3 plus r cos theta and r sine theta. And if we write parametric coordinate for this ellipse, we'll write it as 5 cos phi and 4 sine phi. Now it's the same point, right? So that means these two values, they must be same. So we'll write 3 plus r cos theta equals 5 cos phi and r sine theta must be equal to 4 sine phi. Now what we'll do is we'll try and eliminate theta. So we'll write r square cos square theta plus r square sine square theta, which will be simply r square, and then it'll be minus 3 plus 5 cos phi whole square plus 4 sine phi whole square. So we write r square as 9 plus 25 cos square phi minus 30 cos phi and plus 16 sine square phi. Now 16 sine square phi plus 16 cos square phi will be 16. So we can write this equation as r square equals 9 cos square phi minus 30 cos phi and then plus 25. So radius of this circle is a function of, now we can write this as 3 cos phi minus 5 whole square. So radius of this circle will be 5 minus 3 cos phi. Now, since this circle, it lies inside this ellipse, so this radius r, it should be less than this distance, which is 5 minus 3. So it should be less than or equal to 2. So from here, we can write 3 cos phi and it should be greater than or equal to 3. So from here, we'll get this condition, which is cos phi is greater than or equal to 1. Now, value of cos theta, it can never be greater than 1. So the only solution that we'll get from here is the value of cos phi. It should be 1. And if the value of cos phi is 1, we'll get value of r as 2. So for this circle, radius must be 2 units. And that's your option number C. Now here the question is, consider an ellipse and a concentric circle. The circle passes through focus of ellipse and intersects the ellipse in 4 distinct points. The length of major axis of ellipse is 15 units. And if S1 and S2 are focus of ellipse, an area of triangle PS1 S2 is 26 square units, then eccentricity of ellipse is equal to which of the following value? Now we are given an ellipse and a concentric circle, and circle passes through focus of this ellipse. So we'll draw this ellipse. And suppose center is C. Now we have a circle which is concentric to this ellipse. And which passes through focus of ellipse, say S1 and S2. Now it intersects this ellipse at four points. Now suppose one of the point of intersection is P. So it is given that length of major axis of this ellipse is 15 units. So that means 2A, it is equal to 15. And area of this triangle PS1, S2 is 26 square units. So area of this triangle, it is 26 square units. Now we know that this point P, it lies on ellipse. So it'll satisfy its focal property. So from here we'll write PS1 plus PS2, and it must be equal to 2A, and 2A in this case is 15. Now, since S1, S2 is diameter and this point P, it lies on circle. So that means this angle is 90 degrees. So area of this triangle simply will be half base into altitude. So we write 1 by 2 PS1 into PS2, and this value, it must be 26. So from here we write PS1 into PS2, and this value, it must be equal to 52. Now we'll take PS1 as say X and PS2 as Y. So we'll get two equations, which are value of X plus Y is 15 and X into Y is simply 52. Now we can write X minus Y. So X minus Y square will be X plus Y square minus 4XY. So we'll write X minus Y square as X plus Y square, which is 225 minus 4XY. So it'll be 208. So from here we'll write X minus Y as plus or minus under root 17. Now we'll add them. We'll get this X as 15 plus minus under root 17 by 2. And we'll subtract. We'll get Y as 15 minus plus under root 17 by 2. So it simply means focal radius, one of them must be 15 plus under root 17 by 2. Say this is PS1, and the other one should be 15 minus under root 17 by 2. Now we need to find eccentricity for this ellipse. So for this right angle triangle, what we can write is, we can write S1 S2 square, and this is equal to PS1 square plus PS2 square. So we'll square and add, we can write this as 225 plus 17 upon 4 into 2. So it'll be S1 S2 whole square, and this value is equal to, now 225 plus 17, so it'll be 242, and 242 divided by 2 is 121. So from here we'll write S1 into S2 is simply 11. So S1 S2 is distance between focus, which is 2AE, and 2AE is 11, and 2A is simply 15. So value of E is simply 11 by 15, and that's your option number D. Now the question is, if this circle, it touches this ellipse from inside, and 2 comma minus 6 is one of the focus of this ellipse, we need to find the value of P and Q. Now center of this circle is at 2 comma minus 3, and its radius is 4 units. And for this ellipse also, center is at 2 comma minus 3. So we have this ellipse. With center at 2 comma minus 3, and then it is this circle which touches this ellipse. Now radius of this circle is 4. So we clearly know that for this ellipse, the point must be 0, 4 and 0, minus 4. So from here we'll say value of Q, it must be 4. Now it says one of the focus is 2, minus 6. So it is 2, minus 6. Now distance between center and focus is simply AE. So we can write A into E, and this value is equal to 3. Now A in this case is simply P. So we'll write P into E as 3 and Q as 4. Now Q square will be P square into 1 minus E square. So it'll be 16, and then it'll be P square minus P square. P square is 9. So value of P is simply 5. So this PQ is 5 and 4, and that's your option number 2. Now example 24, it says a line passing through the extremity A of major axis and B of the minor axis of ellipse meets the auxiliary circle at a point N, then the area of triangle with vertices AM and origin is. Now the equation of this ellipse is x square upon 9 plus y square upon 1 equals to 1. So value of A is simply 3 and value of B is 1. Now a line passing through vertices A and B. Now A is on major axis. So A will be 3, 0 and B it will be 0, 1. So equation of this line will be x upon 3 plus y upon 1 and it is equal to 1. Now it says this line, it meets the auxiliary circle at the point M. So we know that equation of auxiliary circle is x square plus y square equals a square, and a square in this case is 9. We need to find area of triangle with vertices at A, M and origin. So we have this ellipse. And then we have origin, which is 0, 0. And then we also have A, which is 3, 0. And then we have auxiliary circle, a line through A and B. So this is A and that's B. It intersects the circle at this point M. We need to find area of this triangle, which is O, A and M. So for this M, we need to find its y coordinate. So what we'll do is we'll eliminate x from this equation. So we'll put the value of x, we'll put the value of x as 3 into 1 minus y, and we'll put it in this equation. So we'll put value of x here, we'll get 9 1 plus y square minus 2y plus y square equals to 9. Now here 9 and 9 will cancel, we'll get 10 y square minus 18 y equals to 0. So we'll get either y as 0 or we'll get y as 18 by 10, which is simply 9 by 5. So for this point M, its y coordinate will be 9 by 5 because we already have 0 for this point A. So we need not find its x coordinate. We just need to find its area. So its area will be half and then base is 3 units and its height. Height is simply 9 by 5. So it'll be 27 by 10. So area of this triangle OAM will be 27 by 10 square units. Now the question is, equation of the largest circle with center at 1, 0 that can be inscribed in the ellipse, which is x square upon 16 plus y square upon 4 equals to 1. So we have this ellipse. Whose center is at origin and vertices are 4, 0, minus 4, 0, it is 0, 2 and 0, minus 2. And then it says we need to find equation of the largest circle with center at 1, 0. So center of the circle is at 1, 0 and which is inscribed in this ellipse. Now we know that the circle with center at 1, 0 and which touches this ellipse will have maximum radius. So we need to find the maximum value of r so that this circle, it touches this ellipse. So we can write equation of the circle as x minus 1 square plus y square and it is equal to r square, and this circle, it must lie within this ellipse, which is x square plus 4y square equals 16. So basically this circle, it should be tangent to this ellipse. Now if this circle is tangent to this ellipse, then this circle and ellipse, they should intersect only at one value of x. So what we'll do is we'll eliminate y from this equation. So we'll write 4 and y square is r square minus x minus 1 square and it'll be equal to 16 minus x square. So this equation is 4 r square minus 4x square minus 4 plus 8x and it will be 16 minus x square. So we'll get this equation as 3x square minus 8x 20 minus 4r square equals 0. Now, this circle and ellipse, they are tangent to each other. So that means they should have only one point of intersection. That is, the value of D, it should be 0. So we'll put D as 0. We'll get B square, which is 64 minus 4A, which is 12. And then we can take 4 common also. So it'll be 4 and then 5 minus R square. It should be 0. So we can divide it by 16. So it'll be 4 minus 3. 5 minus R square equals to 0. So we'll get 3R square equals 11. So value of R square should be 11 by 3. So now we'll put the value of R square and that's the answer to this question. So it'll be X minus 1 square plus Y square and it is equal to 11 by 3. So equation of this circle will be 3X square plus 3Y square minus 6X. And it'll be 3, 3 minus 11, and 3 minus 11 is simply 8. So that's your option number C.